get all your friends to start saving your D batteries, because these are awesome sources for graphite anodes. Just hammer them a little bit, loosen them up, take that anode out. The rest can go into normal battery recycling. See what these graphite electrodes and a D-cell battery, a dead D-cell battery, incidentally, have a lot of uses. Graphite products are not necessarily cheap. I think these things are good for, obviously, for what we're using it for, as an anode for electroplating, just really for metal recovery. Okay, so I'm saying I got all the junk burned out of it. Actually, stainless steel, little strips of stainless steel would probably work best. This copper may get attacked. When you're taking apart this old electronic stuff, it definitely pays to save, especially the stainless steel screws. I'll use this larger screw to attach my lead wire onto. Now the only thing left to do is to let this cool, and then we're going to attach our coffee filter. Don't run the coffee filter all the way up around this stuff. You don't want it to wick acid up onto the copper. We want to try to keep this, all this metal on the anode side, out of the solution. Put them in the coffee filter, like so. Actually, boy, if I had more clothespins, I think I would just use clothespins for this job. So we'll just have to see on all that stuff how it is. So there we go. There's a put the rubber band up as high as it'll go. Going to be, anodes have a very rough life. You would never want to be an anode, an electrolytic cell. So there's the assembly. This is, I think, to, what is it, supply electrons? I'm not sure. Maybe it's where the electrons go. The main thing is it hooks up to the positive terminal of the power supply.